Hi friends, this is Dr. Shadab. I welcome all of you to my YouTube channel, Health Knowledge Channel. Today we are talking about high blood pressure, or we call it hypertension. And I'll tell you why it happens, why most of the people around the world are suffering from this silent killer. People call it silent killer because most of the time there are no symptoms arise in a human body. And what is blood pressure? Let's talk about it. Blood pressure is a pressure which, like our heart, is a pumping machine. So when blood goes through our heart, heart pumps the blood and sends the whole blood to the whole body. So in this process there are two types of pressure. One is systolic and second is diastolic. And usually the normal blood pressure is 120/80, the limit, the borderline is 140/90. If a person has more than 140 or more than 90, the lower one, he'll be considered as type 1 hypertension. And there are type 2 secondary hypertension also, which is 160/100 or more than that. So there are many reasons, there are many causes for this silent killer. Today we'll discuss what are its symptoms, what are the causes, and what are the possible treatments. So first, let me tell you, this disease, this condition arises from eating bad food. The size of our stomach is like this. This is only this. This is the size of a human stomach. When we are taking too much, more than what is required to our stomach, so what it happens? The whole food is not digested. We have acidity, heart burning, we feel dizzy, lethargic, we are feeling dull, we are feeling sleepy, we are not good, and actually we do not exercise, so our blood pressure increases. So if we fast, like in the month of Ramadan you're fasting, or many people also fast, so when you fast, your blood pressure is low. And when you're taking food all the time, eating something junk food, food from outside, you're taking cold drink all the time, a lot of calories you are taking, more than your body required, so your blood pressure shoots. Okay, what are the symptoms? Now let's talk about the symptom. The symptom of high blood pressure or hypertension is the person will be having pain here. This part on the back of the head, there'll be pain. And he'll be having palpitation, he may have dizziness, he may have shortness of breath, and he has to pant, he has to gasp. Like once he or she goes up on the stairs, or comes downstairs, or when they try to do some rigorous exercise, or when they walk, brisk walking, they feel shortness of breath, they feel dizziness, giddiness, vertigo, and they feel that they're not able to breathe properly. So these may be the symptoms, or there are maybe more symptoms, and sometimes your heartbeat is abnormal, or sometimes your heartbeat is skipped. It skips, your heart skips the beats, or you feel like your heartbeat is more than normal. A healthy human has heartbeats, it's the range from 70 to 100. If you have more than 100, so people can assume that you have a history of heart disease, or you may have blood pressure. So these are the symptoms, and headache, nausea, or as I told you that tachycardia, these are the symptoms of high blood pressure. Sometimes these symptoms go unnoticed. A person does not feel anything. He does not. Sometimes they feel only like the heart is clutched, like there is stiffness in the heart, or there is sharp shooting, stabbing pain in the chest area, or sometimes on the back of the heart there is numbness, there is pain, or some people also feel angina. There is a pain when your heart does not get the proper amount of oxygenated blood, so the patient may feel pain in their hand, the left hand, or the back, or jaw, or shoulder, or left side of the body. So it also may be the reason of high blood pressure. Now let's talk why it occurs. There are first I told you that when we are not eating properly, so our blood pressure may arise. Second is obesity. If you're obese, if your body mass index is more than normal, you are prone to hypertension, and your lifestyle is sedentary. You do not work out, you do not exercise, you keep on sitting for hours, or you're watching TV, eating foods, eating snacks, the food in high calories you are consuming, so you may be get this condition. Also some people have this hypertension due to the anxiety. When they are stressed, they have tension, they are thinking about their future, how it will happen, what will happen. They are passing through bad circumstances, so it results in the high blood pressure or hypertension. So the one who does not feel good, who does not have proper amount of sleep, 6 to 7 hours a day, so he also may be the victim of this hypertension. So I request all of you to maintain your healthy lifestyle, and now come to the medications. In allopathy there are many kind of medications, like there are calcium channel blockers, or there are diuretics, and there are many type of medicines. But in allopathy, once you start taking allopathic medicines, you have to continue it for a couple of years, and you are bound to take them for a long time. Today I'm telling you the medicines in homeopathy where you do not have to take the homeopathy medicine for just for a couple of months. You can take, and once you take a dose, you'll feel very good. Your blood pressure, whether you are having blood pressure from anxiety or any reason, maybe your blood pressure will come to normal within couple of minutes. So I'll tell you two medicines which are really helpful in hypertension. So the first medicine in homeopathy for hypertension is Rauwolfia serpentina mother tincture. This is a mother tincture or cube. once you visit the homeopathy medical store, ask them for this one, Raul Fia Serpentina Mother Tincture. This is the best medicine for hypertension. Take 10 drops thrice a day. Take 10 drops in the morning and in the evening or and at night, and your systolic diastolic pressure will be normal. There are no side effects of this remedy, of this medicine. And another medicine for hypertension is this one, Passiflora Incarnata. And if people have anxiety or from the mind, so you have this kind of problem, so Passiflora Incarnata helps the best in this for this type of disease. So hope you enjoy the video. I have told you the two medicines. The first medicine is Passiflora Incarnata Mother Tincture. The second one is Raulfia Serpentina. Take these medicines thrice a day. And let me know, suggest me, let me know how you're feeling. And if you have anything to say, if you want any disease to be discussed, do let us know. Please like, subscribe and share our channel so that you can get the another more videos. Thank you so much.